Hi, the project that I have done in my master's degree is artificial neural networks based load forecasting techniques. As we all know, electrical energy is one of the most valuable things on earth. Storage in large bulks is not possible practically. We have to keep a balance between the production and consumption of electrical energy. Another factor that affects the energy consumption are different weather conditions like rainfall, wind speed, air pressure, humidity, temperature, etc. These factors create a gap between production and consumption of energy. Forecasting of load is very important. As our main focus is on short-term load forecasting technique using artificial neural networks. Many researchers have done a lot of research on different forecasting techniques like regression, support vector machines, genetic algorithm, fuzzy logic, soft computing techniques, etc. But ANN based time series short-term load forecasting is being widely used in power industry. The performance of ANN models are better than other traditional techniques and it's more accurate and produce less prediction errors. Some hybrid methods have been proposed by researchers to optimize ANN algorithm performance. The main aim of my project was to study the performance of artificial neural networks for short-term load forecasting in MATLAB. Many factors are affecting the load, but none of the developed methods are applicable to all power systems. And we have to choose different prediction models according to different power load conditions. So I've studied different environmental conditions to optimize the ANN model. Another tricky thing in my research was to select a proper data set, because without a data set, we cannot design a proper neural network model. I have selected ISO New England early load dataset consisting of 39,408 data points. In that dataset, there are 5 inputs: ears, hours, dry bulb, dew point, and actual load. So I have generated some of the inputs from the program, and I have also taken holidays as an input. The dataset consists of 4.5 years from January 2017 up to June 2021. I have used fitting neural network function in MATLAB, which takes a row vector of n hidden layers and a big propagation training function and return a feed forward neural network. So the training function that I have used was Levenberg-Marquardt training function. Beside that, I have also used Bayesian regularization, but the performance of Levenberg-Marquardt was quite better than other training functions. Finally, I have compared the results with other literature, with different literature papers. So my main objectives were to study the short-term load forecasting techniques in different research papers and increase the number of inputs to study the performance of model. I have used multiple linear regression to compare my results. Unluckily, I couldn't optimize my neural network model using hybrid techniques. I have tested my model on weekly and daily load data. This is my flowchart, and let's move to MATLAB programming. I will only discuss few of the points. I have loaded my data point in my MATLAB and then split that data into text and numerical data. I have converted my date into numbers, and after that I'm using these 3 inputs. I am also reading holidays from Excel file, and these are my inputs: hours, date, dry bulb, dew point, day of week, working days, holidays, previous day SMR load. These are my inputs, and load is my output. So actually I have divided my whole data set into 2 sections: input data and output data, and actual load is my output data. So based on these data, I will further divide my data into training and testing data. These are the different plots, and this is my regression function, which is finding the relationship between regression of inputs and outputs, and based on the regression, it is generating predicted outputs. So here is my prediction. It's my regression plot. The differences can be seen easily, which shows that it is not much accurate. Here it's my training data and that is my test data. So my inputs are X and my output is Y, and I have used these two as training data, while some of the data is taken as test data. So this is actually my weekly ANN model program. So I have taken the last week of June 2021 is my test data, while another all data points are selected as training data. I have already discussed about FitNet. I have used 30 new number of neurons to train my network using Levenberg-Marquardt training function, training algorithm. After my neural network model, I am training my network using this function, which is train. It's training input and output. Here in this step, I am testing my data on the test input data, and I will get the test output data. So based on these two, I will get the mean absolute error and mean absolute percentage error. So these are actually evaluation matrices for measuring forecasting performance. After that, we are getting a regression plot. This is my regression plot for weekly load data, which is 0.99847, which is quite better. And this is a visual representation of my neural network model. So here you can see that there are weights, there are biases, 8 inputs, and these are activation. This is activation function whose inputs are the summation of weights, biases, and inputs. This is actually hidden layer, and that is output layer. I have used these two layers, and these are inputs and one output we will get finally. In the output layer, we have used pure linear activation function. I'm getting best performance on epoch 155. Here we can see the stability between the validation, testing, and training data. This is FitNet equation. B2 and B1 are bias values. LW, RW, these are weights. And it is applying tangent sigmoid function. Beside FitNet, there are some other neural networks in the neural network toolbox in MATLAB, which is PatternNet, Time Delay Net, NARNet, NarxNet, Full Feed Forward Net, Cascade Forward Net. I have studied few of them, like NarxNet and Feed Forward Net, but I have considered as FitNet best of them for our data set. And I have studied many research papers related to short-term load forecasting, medium-term load forecasting, and long-term load forecasting. And I have noticed that the short-term load forecasting is widely applicable. I have increased my inputs to 8. I was trying to increase the inputs more than 8, but due to lack of time, I couldn't do that. And I have observed the variations of load and due to different inputs, like temperature is considered as one of the major element in changing the load of the day. Like in summer and winter, we can see the variations of load. After comparing the results with the multiple linear regression, I have noticed that our results are far better than multiple linear regression. Our model was trained and tested for weekly as well as daily load data. So I have used the same model for weekly load data as well as daily load data. So finally, I have concluded that ANN is able to perform linear as well as non-linear modeling and adaptation. So it is its learning capacity is very good. It's easily learning the data, it's training on the data, and it's learning on from the trained data, and on that learning it give the output to predict the future values. So neurons are considered as the basic parameters to tune ANN model, because I have tested the model for different number of neurons on trial and error basis. And I have noticed that neurons can be properly selected to increase the performance of the ANN model. While studying different training algorithms, as I have noticed the performance of different training algorithm, but Levenberg-Marquardt was considered as the best because it is faster than other training algorithms like Bayesian regularization and gradient descent. I have also tested the Bayesian regularization, but it was very slow. Temperature is one of the major elements in varying loads. and best performance curve I achieved for daily load data when I selected 35 neurons and having the lowest MAP error of 0.82. So in this case, as this is my weekly load data, so I'm getting 1.67% error with the regression value of 0.9847. So this is my regression, this is my training, validation, testing, and all regression plots. This is the difference, that is the comparison between actual and forecasted load data. So I have to want to compare some of my results with some of the research, other research papers, like the authors divide the data in different seasons, spring, summer, and fall, winter, and find the MAP error and RMS error, root mean square error. And here it's calculating the predicted load for different times. This is the plot between actual and predicted loads. And its regression value is 0.82885, which is quite low than our designed network model. In this model, they have used two separate techniques like neural network and cluster, and find the performance of both of them. Finally, these are some of the research papers that I have studied for my research. And thank you.